Mayer around here anyway? Chauffeur or a butler? How many get him?
What are you talking about?
You asked me a question. How many get him?
None.
Get him, please.
Boy,
hit up. The guy in the fishing. Now they make themselves at home,
we'll be right in. You got $500 for that old tightwad. That's impossible.
Well, that's what he paid. So Jerry, do a fan dance.
Jerry, better be. Did you mean to say that you let Jerry do a fan dance?
That was my theory. It wasn't my idea.
Whatever, well, you better do it. My sister doing a fan dance.
Don't get excited, dear. It was perfectly all right.
Hi, Jerry.
Oh, hello, Jerry.
Geraldine, did you do a fan dance?
Well, of course. Why not?
But I think it's perfect. It wasn't dreadful at all. As a matter of fact, it was very good, wasn't it, Jerry?
Yes, it was. You know, you should be in the theater.
Jerry, I don't want you to put those ridiculously wild ideas into your head. Jerry! You know what I just heard?
What is Lowe's?
Can you imagine that screwy thing doing a fan dance for charity?
What do they know about charity? Hundreds of families would be glad for a 10-cent loaf of bread. Here they are eating caviar at $11 a pound. $19.50 a pound.
Listen. You know they're always sending out checks for charity.
So what? Are they really trying to help somebody out?
Yeah.
Just an excuse for him to do a fan dance.
You know, I shake a pretty wicked fan myself.
Good stuff you've been picking. You need it? Can we come out of coffee?
Good afternoon, Kendall.
Good afternoon, then. Carolyn?
She's in the living room. Oh, hello, Mr. Kendall.
Hello. Hello, Mr. Willoughby.
Hello, Mr. Kendall.
Hello. I'm sorry to bring you like this, but I must talk to you. It's very important.
Will you pardon me?
Sorry. Certainly, I was just thinking of going anyway. Yes, goodbye. I'll phone you later. Goodbye. Have you seen the evening paper?
I know. Why?
Read this.
Sure, let me see that. Here it is. Well, why don't we have some new pictures taken? This one is dreadful. Don't you think so, Mr. Kendall?
Yeah. This is what I wanted you to see.
Why, how perfectly done. Why, we saw it only last week. Same with astronaut spirit. What ever made him do a thing like that?
It's not a pleasant story. Fletcher speculated with money that didn't belong to him. When the investigation started, he took the only way out.
Well, I can hardly believe it. And he was such a good friend of father.
That's just it. You know, your father entrusted him with all your affairs.
Poor Mrs. Fletcher.
I'm not thinking of Mrs. Fletcher, but you I'm worried about. Your bank account has been wiped out. Everything you own has been sold. Even mortgage your automobile.
Well, isn't there anything left?
Well, cross-examination was rather hasty. Take a little time to straighten things out.
Yes, I know, but what am I supposed to do in the meantime?
Well, your rent here is paid until the 1st of the year. By that time, I hope I've better news for you. If I can be of any assistance, you know where to call me.
Thanks very much. Keep the chin up, sis. We've still got a roof over our heads. But all that is made up for the 1st of the year.
Yeah, but what are we going to do for food?
Did you ring me?
Yes.
Tell William from the cook to come in here.
Well, what are we going to do?
The first thing to do is let the Sabbath go. I want to tell you that your work has been very satisfactory. But unfortunately, we haven't let you go.
You mean we are defiant? We are decamped?
Not exactly. We'd love to keep you, but we lost our money.
You mean I work for nothing? I won't get paid?
Yes.
Then I resign.
I'm awfully sorry this had to happen. Of course, if you want references, we'll be only too happy to give them to you.
That's fine. But how about my last month's salary?
Your last month's salary?
Yes, I went to Mr. Fletcher. He was busy and said I'd get it all this month.
Well, how much do we owe you?
$100 for last month, $100 for this, $200.
Well, we just can't pay you. We haven't any money.
Oh, dear. I am paying my room rent and waste. I can't go back there without any money.
But what do you expect us to do? Ask you to live here?
Not a bad idea.
How much do you pay for your room?
$10 a week.
And we owe you $200? Okay. You can have a guest room for 20 weeks.
Thank you. I'll move right in.
And how about you?
Me?
I'll take 16 weeks. Have you gone crazy? Are you actually going to let them live here? Certainly. Why not? We get a couple of swell servants for nothing.
Oh, no, you don't. All right, ring for a
Bob's company.
In a Rolls Royce.
Yeah.
Sweetheart, you're in the wrong place. Morning. Sorry, we've got more shoppers we can place.
That's all right, I'll take anything.
Okay.
What's your name?
Tom Williams.
Hey,
study.
Rest?
Manhattan Towers, Park Avenue.
Park Avenue?
Yes.
Education?
Graduate engineer, construction.
I think I've got a job for you.
You won't pay much.
Well, that's all right. I'll take it.
I'll clerk with construction gang.
In Adler?
Sure. When do I start?
Tomorrow morning. Train leaves at 10:30.
Train?
Yes. Job in Philadelphia.
Well, I'm sorry. I can't take it.
How about it? Married?
No.
Oh. Dependent, huh?
Yeah. Dependent.
All right.
Taxi, ready? Come on, Phineas. We'll take that one. New York?
You like a book?
That's good. We're just a visitor here.
Well, what would you like to see? The aquarium? Statue of Liberty?
No. I'm homesick. For grass and trees and horses.
Yes, ma'am.
Listen, Mud.
You don't want any trouble, keep this hack out of here. This is my spot.
Yeah?
I got another one on your shirt.
Uh-huh.
What place is this?
It's a dude ranch, Ma.
Who owns it?
Why, no way. This is Central Park.
Just what I've been hankering for ever since I left Nevada. Grass. And trees.
And horses, Ma.
Sit down.
Thank you. Oh, Ma.
You see, just before Phineas was born, I was reading Little Lord Fauntleroy. And he ain't got over it yet. What's your name, son?
Tom Williams.
My name's Jones. Annie Jones. Back home, the folks call me Pancake Ann.
Oh, Ma.
It ain't nothing to be ashamed of. I live the distant Pancake west of the Mississippi. That is, I used to before I made my money. Well, tickle me with taxes. What sort of duds are those?
It's a riding habit, Ma.
I've seen men shot for lead.
It's the style. All the best people dress like that when they ride.
Is he society?
Oh, yes. See the smart set right here.
Now that you've seen him, are you happy, son?
Oh, no, Ma.
I want to meet him. That's what we come to New York for, ain't it? He'll never stop pestering me until he does. I'd give $1,000 to have him mingle with them folks.
You mean you'd really give $1,000 just to have him meet society?
Yeah. If I ever catch him in one of them, they're riding habits.
Not bad. Liver and onions. Smells good.
Really
nice. Say, do you have any breakfast?
Yeah. Have you ordered champagne?
How about lunch? We all
had champagne.
Is that all
they had? Well, this afternoon they got kind of hungry, so they had.
Hello, and champagne.
Let's see. 65 and $1.14. That makes $1.79. Can't eat at the Ritz on that. I guess we can. There's bound to be somebody there we know who paid the bill. Let's see. We'll have the avocado canapé and mouse sauce.
I don't want any fish.
All right, no fish. We'll have squab and wine sauce, artichoke hollandaise, hothouse strawberry. And a delicate. Is that enough? Perfect. Probably we don't need anyone we know. There you go, spoiling my whole dinner. Can I call him?
No. They want to wait until I come get it.
He's married Gary when he asked him, we wouldn't be worrying about dinner. I'm married now, people say it's for his money.
Well, it's starved.
Well, that's just what we're doing. I wonder what happens before you start to dance. Well, I once read that just before you lose your mind completely, there are the most realistic dreams about good things to eat. Cal! It's happening.
What?
I smell food. These two. Now I've got onions. Liver and onions. What a dream.
Gary, it's no dream.
I know. Because if I ever dream of food, it won't be liver and onions.
You're not a bad cook.
Oh, I have other accomplishments. Hello.
Hello.
I beg your pardon. I hope that I'm saving you.
Not at all. Have some liver and onions?
I don't mind if I do.
Officer.
You have to pardon me, informality. We had a little scissors story. What a coincidence. So did we.
Oh, well, you have some potatoes?
Thank you.
Sarah, I've got something today that might interest you.
Really?
How'd you like to make $1,000?
How?
Well, a woman who's visiting New York engaged me as a sort of guide. She's here with her only son and a lot of money. She'll pay $1,000 to have the boy meet the right people.
I've never heard of such things.
Well, that's a little unusual, but then so is Annie.
Annie?
Yes, her name is Mrs. Annie Jones, but our Western friends call her Pancake Annie.
Well, are you suggesting we introduce her to our friends? Mrs. Van Dyke, I want you to meet up with my old friend, Pancake Annie.
They're really very nice people.
I don't care how nice they are. I'm really amazed at you for even suggesting such a thing.
I'm sorry. I simply thought you might be able to use the money.
I don't care to hear any more about it. Come, darling.
Oh, haven't you forgotten something?
Oh, well, I beg your pardon. Thank you for the dinner.
Never mind that. These dishes have got to be washed, you know?
You're not suggesting that we wash them.
Why not? You've eaten, haven't you? Might as well get this thing straightened out. I'll buy the footman and I'll cook it. You simply have to do your part. All your life you've been living in the fat of the land, but that's all over now. You want to eat? You've got to work. Of course, you don't have to wash the dishes if you don't want to. Then you don't have to eat either.
A couple of 12 servants. For nothing. That's my last notice. But I've got some cricket news from the Junior League shows, if you care to see them.
Yes, I know, but this is the middle of the season, and all the shows are cast.
Well, isn't there anything at all? Nightclub, vaudeville?
Did you ever do a vaudeville act?
No. But I've simply got to have a job. I don't care what it is.
Okay, sister. Go down and see Joe Thomas. He's always looking out for new talent. And here's the address. Just throw an allocation at you. And here. Show him this.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Gibson. Pardon me. Is Mr. Thomas here?
Yes. You find him over there.
You name it, Louis will play it.
Do you know Manhattan Mustang? In every climb, and no matter what the time, nothing, all the calling calls, you'll be fine of that. Not bad things, though it's the same in Greek or Latin. It's not the love fest for Manhattan. You can hear the lovers room. Long lies in a little shack on Fifth Avenue. We'll cuddle and coo. We'll be happy though the place may be small. 12 rooms in all will do. Just a cozy little lovable nest. Away from the rest. And we'll furnish it with no place for room. Not even a room at blue. We must buy a bar to ride in. We have a smart choice. Maybe you'd be satisfied in. A little rose room and a little shack on Fifth Avenue. A mansion for two. With the simple things that make life a song. I'll struggle along with you.
Come here, sister. Let us take a look at your game. Billy. Come on, step back and show me. Come on. Higher, higher. Come on, let's see him. Higher, higher. Let's take a look at him. Up there. Any experience?
Oh, yes, sir.
Say, lady, this is the scandal of burlesque. That fan dance business may be all right for Park Avenue, but it's old stuff down here. I'll show you the kind of stuff we want. Hey, Daisy!
Yeah?
Hang up your hat.
All right.
Okay, Louis. Leave the open spaces, start going places, do a hot job instead of say hey. Grab yourself a locker and nickel buckler and just hang up your hat on Broadway. Lose your comfy habit, don't be a bandit, don't awaken, you take a sun man. Leave the tuna trolley, a folly dolly, we'll make me on in lean man. I can bear a bill of fare, a thunder crown for people. Just let me share the sweet red air that only found in the Bronx. Get sophisticated, inebriated, it's a system you've got to obey. Wear the skirt and fashion around Manhattan and just hang up your hat on Broadway.
Well, that should be what? The more clothes you take off, the more they applaud. The more they applaud, the more you take off. I pay $35 a week. How about it?
No, thanks. I couldn't do that.
Okay, sisters. You ever change your mind?
Drop in, I'll give you a job.
Thanks.
What's the matter, Joe? You stopping the name?
Don't be a sucker. It isn't her. It's the name. The society bunkers are great. Come on. To the open. I'm sorry I spoke that way. Will you forgive me? I didn't mean to hurt your feelings, really, I didn't.
Shoving, pushing, clawing each other like a bunch of insects.
Yes, you're right. They do look like that from up here. But if you get down there, you'll find out they're just normal human beings, working, creating homes. What if they do crowd each other a little? They're struggling for their very existence, and it's not so easy. You've never understood that before, because you've always looked at life from up here.
I never thought of it that way before. It looks a little different now.
That's the spirit.
Hey, if you want dinner, you better come in and give me a hand.
How are you feeling, Darlene?
There's nothing wrong with that, and money won't cure it.
You're right. That's all we do need is money.
Yes, but how are we going to get it? You ever see that pancake person you were telling us about?
Sure, I've been driving her around every day.
Would she still pay to meet the right people?
Jolene, are you serious?
Well, certainly. We can't go on like this any longer. We need money. How do we manage?
I don't know, but I do know that tomorrow I'm driving her over to the riding academy in the park.
That's a right smart looking horse. But what's that on top of it?
Reggie Vandegrift.
Gee, real society.
I'll say so. They've got so much class they wouldn't even need pig's feet unless they had spats on.
Hmm. You know everybody, don't you?
Not exactly. They visit the people I work for. I mean, well, this isn't my car.
I thought it was.
No, someone put that for hire sign on it as a joke, and I carried it through because, well, I sort of needed the money.
William.
Yes, miss.
What's the meaning of this? You told me the car was out of order.
It was, Miss Carroll.
Well, then what are you doing here?
Well, you see,
It ain't his fault, miss. I'm to blame. Maybe you better let me explain. Take my horse to the stable.
Yes, miss.
You see, my taxi broke down, so I hailed your car, and your boy said he couldn't take me no further than this. That's how it happened. Ain't it, Phineas?
Yes, ma.
Excuse me. This is my boy, Phineas.
How do you do?
I'm Annie Jones. Back home they call me Pancake Annie. Pancake Annie. I've heard that name before.
Yeah, when Mark came to New York, they put a picture in the paper.
Oh, you're the squirrel. That's it. You're the one who started with the pancake and ended with the silver mine.
Oh, shucks. It wasn't nothing. I just grubbed a few of the boys.
Well, I'm glad to know you. I'm Carol Stewart.
How do you do?
Mark 6500. Hello. Hello, Jerry. You better have everything ready. I don't know, but she's talking with Miss Carol now.
Oh, good. I'll take care of everything the same. I'm at it, working. Let's go. What's the rush? We'll be here soon. I'll make the salary if I can change. And what part do I play in this? The money, of course. Nobody said anything to me about it. Can't you see how important this is? Not to me, it ain't. As far as I'm concerned, you can include me.
And you can trim my hat with sagebrush, if that ain't the gospel trim.
Don't try to be yours as positively delicious. I took him up here morning. Won't you come and have tea with me?
Now that's real nice of you. Ain't it, Phineas?
Yes, Ma.
Oh, will you?
Yes, miss.
Dick May Ackenfrey. I'm the aide maid.
Where's the next? Andre Oxley.
A French maid.
Oui, oui, ma.
Shall I say see Mrs. Carroll?
Why, yes, please.
You know, Phineas, I always did want to see one of these here outhouses.
Penthouse, ma.
Tell Mrs. Jones, please.
your deal? Where's Annette?
She's in her room. She got temperamental.
Oh, so you're the maid?
Yes.
And I'm the chauffeur?
Yes.
In the best families, the chauffeur always kisses the maid. I have to let me come. Where's Peter? Come on, Annette. Now, what's your idea?
You won't need this anymore. I'm going to shut off the juice.
Well, you can't do that.
Who else will pay your bills?
Well, there must be some mistake. I have a copy of myself. How much is it?
Now, you'll have to take that up to the collection department. I'm on the service. Bye, sweetheart.
Now what do we do? They're waiting for tea.
We're going to store. I'll think of something. But whatever you do, don't let them touch the lights.
Imagine, they use electricity to light cigarettes. Or maybe even cook by electricity. Must be right handy having all those modern improvements.
Have you got enough?
Thank you. I did want to use that.
Oh, why didn't you?
It's nice. His own name is Jay.
What?
Oh, yeah, isn't that a bit?
Oh, I'll take care of it tomorrow.
We'll take 8 later. The Jay is off. You savvy that Volleyball just like a native.
Yeah, just like a native.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I didn't know you were receiving, my dear.
Come in, my dear. Mrs. Jones, I want you to meet Miss Faye. She's my housekeeper.
How do you do, Mrs. Jones? This is indeed a pleasure.
Pleased to meet you, ma'am. I beg your pardon. This is my son, Phineas.
Oh, charmed, I'm sure.
Yes, ma'am.
Geraldine, a cigarette.
Will you lift the bell without order?
Yes, sir. I'll see to it, sir.
Is Miss Carol home?
Well, yes, sir. She's in the living room.
How do you do, Mr. Weatherby?
Don't say anything
about
the name.
Oh,
hello. Mr. Jones, Mr. Weatherby.
And Mr.
Jones.
How do you do?
And Miss Faye.
Mr. Haven't I met you somewhere before?
Oh, I'm sure you haven't. Miss Faye doesn't turn to
Europe. That's it. I never forget a face.
Don't
Bill. No. First, Sebastian.
No.
Now, don't tell me. I never forget a face.
Annette.
That's it. Now I know when I met you. It was now time.
Oh.
Now, wait. Wait, just give me a minute. I'll concentrate.
Annette, will you show Mr. Jones the view?
With pleasure.
Phineas,
come with Miss Faye.
Yes, Ma. I'm sure I've met that young lady somewhere. Phineas, what the devil are you doing?
Preparing tea, sir. Preparing tea?
Certainly, Gary. Haven't you ever had tea?
Well, I really don't know.
With all these here modern improvements, I never thought you'd boil water over an open fire like we do out on the range.
Hello,
sir. Mr. Gary, and Mrs. Jones is from the West. And we're having tea western fashion, in her honor. Now, that's what I call downright sweet of you, trying to make me feel at home. And Phineas thought New York people were so uppity.
Life is such a bore. Just a continual round, party, sentence, and so on.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm so tired, Laura. Oh, how I long for the wholesome life of the great open spaces.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, you're such a comfort.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, Mr. Jones, we really shouldn't be out here alone. People will talk.
Yes, ma'am.
Call me next.
Yes, ma'am. Next.
William, I think tea is ready.
Yes, miss.
You're just in time for tea.
Oh, splendid. I feel just like a dish of tea.
Harold, how can you tolerate such a careless service?
Oh, shucks, that's nothing. That's liable to happen to anybody.
Don't worry. William, go have tea ready in no time.
Oh, don't go to no bother on my account. Do it in your usual way.
No, I insist. It's no bother at all. Harold, dear, why don't you let Mrs. Jones have her own way?
I have an idea. We'll compromise. That's all going to be.
Well, if you insist.
Oh, are you coming, honey?
Oh, you'll have to excuse me. I have a headache. Oh, I'm so sorry, darling.
Oh,
thanks for a lovely time. I'll call you real soon.
Yes, do. Phew, now I have got a headache.
You're not the only.
Well, we certainly made a mess of things.
Me, you have. Gary hasn't told me in 10 days.
That's nothing. I've lost my only cash customer.
And that's nothing. Look at me, having to find maid. Who can that be?
I'll answer it. You better hide. Maybe it's Mrs. Jones. There's a letter for you.
What is that?
My dear Carol, I enjoyed my visit immensely.
You must come and be our guest sometime.
Devotedly. And this. P.S. I almost forgot. Phineas and I are getting married.
call Mrs. Jones before it's too late. She's too nice to have this happen. Hello? Mrs. Annie Jones. What? Are you sure? Well, didn't she leave any forwarding address? All right. Too late, she's gone. Poor Mrs. Jones.
Poor idiot. Poor us. There goes $1,000. We're not any worse off than we were before we started.
I can't make anybody sitting here. I guess I'll take the car out.
You want dinner when you get back?
Sure, why not?
What would you have?
Caviar and champagne.
You'll get whatever it is.
I'll take it.
I suppose now you're going to start downing your stock. No, no, I'm going to keep him there for so he can't walk out on you. Are you thinking McGarry walked out on me? You haven't seen him, McGarry? Well, maybe he will. Text him. I bet he is ill. That's too bad. Don't you think you ought to see him? Good idea, I will. I hope he is sick. For your sake.
Hey, go. And Slug's back again.
Oh, yeah?
Well, watch me. Go get him, Keon, with you.
Hey, yo.
I thought I told you to stay away from here.
This is a public hack stand, isn't it?
Not for you, it ain't. I'm staying right here till somebody moves me.
Oh, yeah?
Well, here's where you move.
What are you crying for?
Because I could swim in on you, but now you won't be able to eat it.
Don't worry. You'll take more than a bump on the head and swim in after that. He's as strong as a horse.
You're out of here, Doc, before I really do get sick.
Okay, young man. I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, Mr.
Oh, thanks.
This is certainly a fine welcome home you've given us.
Now, don't start scolding.
If you have no regard for your own reputation, please have some consideration for your sister and myself.
Now you listen to me, Garrett Weatherby. Just because you're married to my sister, no sign you can tell me what to do.
Mr. Weatherby's right. There's no excuse for this sort of thing.
And you keep out of it. Of all the people in the world, you should be the last one to say anything. And if it hadn't been...
I beg your pardon, Miss Stewart. I forgot myself. It won't happen again. Say, Larry. What is it, officer? Oh.
Beg your pardon.
Never mind.
Sister, you can send it back.
Oh, Mrs. Jones, how do you do?
Hello, Miss Darrell. Come in, children.
The newlyweds. Oh, congratulations. I hope you'll be very happy.
They're just like a couple of lovebirds.
Thank you.
Yes, Ma.
Hello. I want you to come inside.
We just got in to say goodbye.
Well, when are you leaving?
Tomorrow morning.
Did you have a nice honeymoon?
Oh, yes. It was grand.
Did you go too?
Sure. I always did want to see Niagara Falls. It's no good without a honeymoon. So I just tagged along.
Yes?
Mr. Weatherby is driving Miss Geraldine, Mom. We'll be here in a few moments.
I'd like to say goodbye to Tom. You mind?
Well, if I know, goodbye.
Hello, Miss Jones.
You leaving?
Yes.
Where are you going?
I don't know. Anyway, get away from here.
Tom, you were never cut out to be a chauffeur. I'll give you a real job. Why don't you come out west with me?
I'm sorry, but I can't.
What is it? A girl?
No.
You got any money?
Okay, fine.
I owe you $1,000.
No, I can't take it.
Why?
Well, I can't tell you.
Is it on account of Annette?
No, of course not.
Listen, son, you don't have to lie. I was a destitute myself for 20 years, and I spotted her for a pop wrestler the minute I laid eyes on her. I knew it all the time. She's a good girl. And she'll make me a good wife. When I get through with her.
Well, if she's ever half as good as you are, that'll be plenty.
Oh, shucks. The train leaves tomorrow morning at 10. Will you be there?
You bet I will.
You won't be sorry, son. Well, I guess we'd have to be running along. Now, the children. All right, Phineas.
On behalf of my wife and myself, I want to thank you for bringing us together and all you've done for us. If you wonder, if you ever come to Nevada, you must visit us. We'd love to have you.
Well, thank you very much. I'd love to. Yes. Where's Tom with?
He's in his room.
Good. Full of old, screwy-looking outfits.
Annette?
Yes.
Come, children. Goodbye, Miss Carol.
Goodbye, Mr. Jones. Nice to see you. I want to talk to you.
Well, I'm listening.
Why did you walk out on me?
Because I felt like it.
Don't talk to me that way. I'll pass.
No? Why are you listening to me? You were beginning to be a real human being, but just as soon as a few dollars came back into the family, you went right back to what you were, an 18-carat pain in the neck. Well, I wouldn't take it from you if you were the last woman in the world. I am through. I'm quitting. Oh, here. Hello.
Where are you going?
Well, if you must know Nevada, Annie Jones is giving me a real job.
Do you suppose she could use a maid, too?
Why?
What? Even in Nevada, the chauffeur always gives her the maid.
Oh, what's the news?
She is going to dance for you. For a man for the audience, a spice of Paris and a pep of Manhattan. All of these you will see and more when Geraldine dances. What am I doing, ladies and gentlemen? See the fan dance. The famous one and only fan dance.
$100.
$100 is this. $100 is this. Can you imagine how many one of these begin for? Who will make it $200? $200. $200. In the name of sweet charity, I thank you. $200 is this. $200. $200 is this. Lady, could I with her hair, Bob? Do I hear more?
Not sure, son. It's just wild enough to do a fan dance.
Do I hear more?
$500.
$500 is this. Do I hear any more?
Yes, for sweet charity, my dear.
$500. Are you ready, Geraldine? $500 for the third and last time. All right, boys, the band dance.
Don't bother, Williams. I'll drive.
Ma'am, I didn't know. You just follow me.
Thanks, officer.
Yes, ma'am. I'm brother, do you mind telling me what she said to you back there?
Well, if you much know, she told me she had a cut on her nose so bad she could hardly wait.
Annette! Annette! I'm helping Miss Carol in.
Come on, she's old enough to drive herself. That motorcycle car. Speeding again, eh? Better watch out. One of these days we'll get a ticket.
Last week. Same at Aston's, Gerald. What ever made him do a thing like that?
It's not a pleasant story. Fletcher speculated with money that didn't belong to him.
When the investigation started, he took the only way out.
Well, I can hardly believe it. And he was such a good friend of father.
And that's just it. You know, your father entrusted him with all your affairs.
Poor Mrs. Fletcher.
I'm not thinking of Mrs. Fletcher. It's you I'm worried about. Your bank account has been wiped out. Everything you own has been sold. Even mortgage your automobile.
Oh. Isn't there anything left?
Well, of course, the examination was rather hasty. Take a little time to straighten things out.
Yes, I know, but what are we supposed to do in the meantime?
Well, your rent here is paid until the first of the year. By that time, I hope I've got a news for you. If I can be of any assistance, you know where to call me.
Thanks very much. Keep your chin up, sis. We've still got a roof over our heads. But all that is made up for the first of the year.
Yeah, but what are we going to do for food?
Did you ring me?
Yes.
Tell Williams and the cook to come in here.
Yes, ma'am. Well, what are we going to do?
The first thing to do is let the cabin go. I want to tell you that your work has been very satisfactory. But unfortunately, we haven't let you go.
You mean we are the tryout? We are the camp?
Not exactly. We'd love to keep you, but we've lost our money.
You mean I work for nothing? I won't get paid?
Yes.
Then I resign.
I'm awfully sorry this had to happen. Of course, if you want references, we'll be only too happy to give them to you.
That's fine. But how about my last month's salary?
Your last month's salary?
Yes, I went to Mr. Fletcher. He was busy and said I'd get it all this month.
Well, how much do we owe you?
$100 for last month, $100 for this, $200.
Well, we just can't pay you. We have no money.
I don't care. I am paying my room rent and wages. I can't go back there without any money.
But what do you expect us to do? Ask you to live here?
Not a bad idea.
How much do you pay for your room?
$10 a week.
And we owe you $200? Okay, you can have a guest room for 20 weeks.
Thank you. I'll move right in.
And how about you? Me? I'll take 16 weeks. Have you gone crazy? Are you actually going to let them live here? Certainly. Why not? We get a couple of swell servants for nothing.
Job in a Rolls Royce.
Yeah.
Sweetheart, you're in the wrong place.
Morning. Sorry, we've got more shelter than we can place. Well, that's all right. I'll take anything.
Okay.
What's your name? Tom Williams.
8:30.
Minutes?
Manhattan Towers, Park Avenue.
Park Avenue?
Yeah.
Education?
Graduate engineer, construction.
I think I've got a job for you.
You won't pay much.
Well, that's all right. I'll take it.
Well, clerk with construction gang.
In Hadley?
Sure.
When do I start?
Tomorrow morning. Train leaves at 10:30.
Train?
Yes. Job in Philadelphia.
Well, I'm sorry. I can't take it.
How about it? Married?
No.
Oh. Dependent, huh?
Yeah. Dependent.
All right.
Taxi ready? Come on, Phineas. We'll take that one.
Where to, lady?
Do you know New York?
Like a book.
That's good. We're just a visiting here.
Well, what would you like to see? The aquarium? Statue of Liberty?
No. I'm homesick. The grass and trees and horses.
Yes, ma'am.
Listen, love. If you don't want any trouble, keep this hack out of here. This is my spot.
Yeah?
I got another one on your shirt.
Uh-huh.
What place is this?
It's a dude ranch, Ma.
Who owns it?
Why, no way. This is Central Park.
Just what I've been hankering for ever since I left Nevada. Grass. And trees.
And horses, Ma.
Sit down.
Thank you. Oh, Ma.
You see, just before Phineas was born, I was reading Little Lord Fauntleroy. And he ain't got over it yet. What's your name, son?
Tom Williams.
My name's Jones. Annie Jones. Back home, the folks call me Pancake again.
Oh, Ma.
It ain't nothing to be ashamed of. I make the best pancakes west of the Mississippi. That is, I used to before I made my money. Well, tickle me with cactus. What sort of duds are those?
It's a riding habit, Ma.
I've seen men shot for lead.
It's the style. All the best people dress like that when they ride.
Is he society?
Oh, yes. See the smart set right here.
Now that you've seen him, are you happy, son?
Oh, no, Ma.
I want to meet him. That's what we come to New York for, ain't it? He'll never stop pestering me until he does. I'd give $1,000 to have him mingle with them folks.
You mean you'd really give $1,000 just to have him meet society?
Yeah. If I ever catch him in one of them, they're riding habits. Wine sauce, artichoke hollandaise, hothouse strawberry, and a dunnet. Is that enough?
Perfect. Probably we don't need anyone we know.
There you go, spoiling my whole dinner. Can I call him?
No. We want to wait let him come get it.
He's married Gary. When he asked him, we wouldn't be worrying about dinner.
I married now, people say it's for his money.
Well, it's starved.
Well, that's just what we're doing. I wonder what happens before you start to bed.
Well, I once read that just before you lose your mind completely, you have the most realistic dreams about the good things to eat.
Carol, It's happening.
What?
I smell food. Me too. Smells like onions. Liver and onions. What a dream.
Gary, it's no dream.
I know. But if I ever dream of food, it won't be liver and onions.
You're not a bad cook.
Oh, I have other questions. Hello.
Hello.
I beg your pardon. I hope that I'm saving you.
Not at all. Have some liver and onions?
I don't mind if I do.
Up.
You have to pardon me, informality. What a coincidence. So did we.
Oh, you have some potatoes?
Thank you.
Sarah, I bought something today that might interest you.
Really?
How'd you like to make $1,000?
How?
A woman who's visiting New York and gives me as a sort of guide. She's here with her only son and a lot of money. And she'll pay $1,000 to have the boy meet the right people.
I never heard of such things.
Well, that's a little unusual, but then so is Annie.
Annie?
Yes, her name is Mrs. Annie Jones, but our Western friends call her Pancake Annie.
Well, are you suggesting we introduce her to our friend? Mrs. Van Dyke, I want you to meet up with my old friend, Pancake Annie.
They're really very nice people.
I don't care how nice they are. I'm really amazed that you've been suggesting such a thing.
I'm sorry. I simply thought you might be able to use the money.
I'm sorry to hear any more about it.
Oh, haven't you forgotten something?
Oh, well, I beg your pardon. Thank you for the dinner.
Never mind that. These dishes have got to be washed, you know?
You're not suggesting that we wash them.
Why not? You've eaten, haven't you? Might as well get this thing straightened out. I'll buy the food and never cook it. You simply have to do your part. All your life you've been living in the fat of the land, but that's all over now. You want to eat? You've got to work. Of course, you don't have to wash the dishes if you don't want to. And you don't have to eat it either.
A couple of swell servants. For nothing. That's my last notice. But I've got some good videos from the Junior League shows. You can't see them.
Yes, I know. But this is the middle of the season. And all the shows are cast.
Well, isn't there anything at all? Nightclub, vaudeville?
Did you ever do a vaudeville act?
No. Well, I've simply got to have a job. I don't care what it is.
Okay, sister. Go down and see Joe Thomas. He's always looking out for new talent. Here's the address. Just throw an allocation at you. And here. Show him this.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Gibson. Pardon me. Is Mr. Thomas there?
Yeah, you find him over there.
All right, make me laugh. What do you do, Irish, Dutch?
No, I think
so. Except for my money.
Well, it's mine's terrific. I can take a buck like nobody. I take a ball, it looks like I broke my neck. Here, lady, hold this. You watch this.
Not bad.
I haven't any music with me.
Oh, that's all right. You name it, Louie will play it.
Do you know Manhattan Mustang?
Sorry I spoke that way. Will you forgive me? I didn't mean to hurt your feelings, really, I didn't. Hello. Now, let's start all over again. I'm sorry.
That's not what you said first.
Oh, isn't it?
No. You said, I'm sorry I spoke that way. Will you forgive me?
Well, then why didn't you answer me?
I don't know. I wouldn't agree with you anyway.
What were you crying for?
Until today, I never realized how rotten people could be. Look at them down there. Lying around, shoving, pushing, crowding each other like a bunch of insects.
Yes, you're right. They do look like that from up here. But if you get down there, you'll find out they're just normal human beings, working, creating homes. What if they do crowd each other a little? They're struggling for their very existence, and it's not so easy. You've never understood that before, because you've always looked at life from up here.
I never thought of it that way before. It looks a little different now.
That's the spirit.
Hey!
Charlene. There's nothing wrong with that money, Monsieur. You're right. That's all we do need is money.
Yes, but how are we going to get it?
You ever see that handshake person you were telling us about?
Sure, I've been driving her around every day.
Would she still pay to meet the right people? Charlene, are you serious? Well, certainly. We can't go on like this any longer. We need money. How do we manage?
I don't know. But I do know that tomorrow I'm driving her over to the riding academy in the park.
That's a right smart looking horse. But what's that on top of it?
Reggie Vandegrift.
Gee, real society.
I'll say so. They've got so much class they wouldn't even need pig's feet unless they had spats on.
Oh. You know everybody, don't you?
Not exactly. They visit the people I work for. I mean, well, this isn't my car.
I thought it was.
No, someone put that for hire sign on it as a joke, and I carried it through because, well, I sort of needed the money.
William.
Yes, miss.
What's the meaning of this? You told me the car was out of order.
It was, Miss Carroll.
Well, then what are you doing here?
Well, you see,
It ain't his fault, miss. I'm to blame. Maybe you better let me explain. Take my horse to the stable.
Yes, miss.
You see, my taxi broke down, so I hailed your car, and your boy said he couldn't take me no further than this. That's how it happened. Ain't it, Phineas?
Yes, Ma.
Excuse me. This is my boy, Phineas.
How do you do? How do you do?
I'm Annie Jones. Back home, they call me Pancake Annie. Pancake Annie. I've read that name before.
And when Ma came to New York, they put a picture in the paper.
Oh, you're the squirrel. That's it. You're the one who started with the pancake and ended with the silver mine.
Oh, shucks. It wasn't nothing. I just grubbed a few of the boys.
Well, I'm glad to know you. I'm Carol Stewart.
How do you do?
Mark 6500. Hello. Hello, Jerry. You better have everything ready. I don't know, but she's talking with Miss Carol now.
Oh, good. I'll take care of everything the same. Annette, working. Let's go. What's the rush? We'll be here soon. I'll let the sound get by your change. And what part do I play in this? The money, of course. Nobody said anything to me about it. Can't you see how important this is? Not to me, it ain't. As far as I'm concerned, you can include me.
And you can trim my hat with sagebrush, if that ain't the gospel truth.
Don't try to be yours as positive resolution. I took him up your morning. Won't you come have tea with me?
Now, that's real nice of you. Ain't it, Phineas?
Yes, Ma.
Oh, will you?
Yes, miss.
But, Geraldine.
Dick May Atkinson. I'm the aide maid.
Where's the next? André Oxnay.
A French maid.
Oui, oui, Ma.
Shall I say, see, Mr. Carroll?
Why, yes, please.
You know, Phineas, I always did want to see one of these here outhouses.
Penthouse, Ma?
Tell Mrs. Jones, please.
Oh, no. What's the idea? Where's the net?
She's in her room. She got them in the middle.
Oh, so you're the maid?
Yes.
And I'm the chauffeur?
Yes.
In the best families, the chauffeur always kisses the maid. I have to let become a worse leader. Now, what's the idea?
You won't need this anymore. I'm going to shut off the juice.
Well, you can't do that.
Well, why don't you pay your bills?
Well, it might be some mistake. I have a cocktail myself. How much is it?
Now, you'll have to pick that up with the collection department. I'm only service.
Now what do we do? They're waiting for tea.
Well, you go in the store. I'll think of something. But whatever you do, don't let them touch the lights.
Imagine, they use electricity to light cigarettes. Why, we even cook by electricity. Must be right handy having all those mountain improvements.
Have you got a match?
Thank you. I did want to use that.
Oh, why didn't you?
It's nice. His own name was Jay.
What?
Oh, yeah, isn't that Hank Hale?
I'll take care of it tomorrow. We'll say eight later. Use Jay is off.
You savvy that Bollywood just like a native.
Yeah, just like a native. Oh, I beg your pardon. I didn't know you were receiving, my dear.
Come in, my dear.
Mrs. Jones, I want you to meet Miss Faye. She's my husband.
How do you do, Mrs. Jones? This is indeed a pleasure.
Pleased to meet you, ma'am. I beg your pardon. This is my son, Phineas.
Oh, charmed, I'm sure.
Yes, ma'am.
Geraldine, a cigarette.
William, the bell is out of order. Yes, sir, I'll see to it, sir.
Is Miss Carol at home?
Well, yes, sir, she's in the living room.
Why, Jerry, what's the... How do you do, Mr. Weatherby?
Don't say anything about the name.
Hello, Gary.
Oh, hello.
Mr. Jones, this is Mr. Weatherby.
Mr. Jones.
And Mr. Jones.
How do you do?
How do you do?
And Miss Faye.
Miss, haven't I met you somewhere before?
Oh, I'm sure you haven't. Miss Faye just returned from Europe.
That's it. I never forget a face. Don't, Bill.
No.
First San Sebastian?
No, no.
And I don't tell me. I never forget a face.
Annette.
That's it. Now I know when I met you. It was now time.
No.
Now wait, just give me a minute. I'll concentrate.
Annette, will you show Mr. Jones the view?
With pleasure.
Phineas, go with Miss Bay.
Yes, Ma. I'm sure I've met that young lady somewhere. Williams, what the devil are you doing? Preparing tea, sir. Preparing tea?
Certainly, Gary. Haven't you ever had tea?
Well, I really don't know.
With all these here modern improvements, I never thought you'd boil water over an open fire like we do out in the rain.
You see, Gary, and Mrs. Jones is from the West, and we're having tea West in fashion, in her honor.
Now, that's what I call downright sweet of you, trying to make me feel at home. And Phineas thought New York people were so uppity.
Life is such a bore. Just to continue around, talk, and spend with people.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm so tired, Laura. Oh, how I long for the wholesome life of the great open spaces.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, you're such a comfort.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, Mr. Jones, we really shouldn't be out here alone. People will talk.
Yes, ma'am.
Call me next.
Yes, ma'am. Next.
Williams, I think tea is ready.
Yes, miss.
You just in time for tea.
Oh, splendid. I feel just like a dish of tea.
Harold, how can you tolerate such a careless service? Oh, shucks, that's nothing. That's liable to happen to anybody.
Oh, don't worry. We'll go have tea with you, no
bother. Oh, don't worry, no bother on my account. Do it in your usual way.
No, I insist. It's no bother at all. Harold, dear, haven't let Mrs. Jones have her own way.
I have an idea. We'll compromise. That's all there is.
Well, if you insist.
Oh, are you welcome, my dear?
Oh, you'll have to excuse me. I have a headache. Oh, I'm so sorry, darling.
Oh, good.
Thanks for a lovely time. I'll call you real soon.
Yes, do. Phew. Now I have got a headache.
You're not the only.
Well, we certainly made a mess of things.
Me, you have. Gary hasn't told me in 10 days.
That's nothing. I've lost my only cash customer.
And that's nothing. Look at me, having to buy a maid. Good grief, who can that be?
I'll answer it. You better hide. Maybe it's Mrs. Jones. There's a letter for you.
My dear Carol, I enjoyed my visit immensely.
You must come and be our guest sometime.
Devotedly. And this. P.S. I almost forgot. Phineas and I are getting married.
Circle 74745. I'm going to call Mrs. Jones before it's too late. She's too nice to have this happen. Hello? Mrs. Annie Jones. What? Are you sure? Well, didn't she leave any forwarding address? All right. Too late, she's gone. Poor Mrs. Jones.
Poor Phineas. Poor us. There goes $1,000. We're not any worse off than we were before we started.
I can't make anybody sitting here. I guess I'll take the car out.
You want dinner when you get back?
Sure, why not?
What would you have?
Caviar and champagne.
You'll get whatever it is.
I'll take it.
I suppose now you're going to start downing your stock. No, no, I'm going to keep him barefoot so he can't walk out. Are you leaving McGarry walk out on me? You haven't seen him lately, have you? Well, maybe he will. Fact is, I bet he is ill. That's too bad. Don't you think you ought to go see him? Good idea, I will. I hope he is sick. For your sake.
Hey, Gil. That slug's back again.
Oh, yeah?
Well, watch me.
We're getting down with you.
Hey, yo.
I thought I told you to stay away from here. This is a public hack stand, isn't it? Not for you, it ain't. I'm staying right here till somebody moves me.
Oh, yeah?
Well, here's where you move.
What are you crying for?
Because I could swim in onion, but now you won't be able to eat it.
Don't worry. You think more than a bump on the head to spoil him after that. He's as strong as a horse. You're out of here, Doc, before I really do get sick. Okay, young man. See you tomorrow.
Hi
there, Mr. Oh, thanks.
How do you feel? All right.
Are you sure?
Certainly. What's the matter?
Listen. Gary feels fine. Stop. Wouldn't take no for an answer. Stop. Leaving on honeymoon. Stop. We'll be back in a few days. Stop. Mom. Carol, now how do you feel?
Terrible.
Get out of that bed. I don't feel so good myself.
You're showing remarkable improvement for only 5 days.
He had nothing to do with it. Why don't you show it up to you and all the stuff in there?
Yeah. I'm having a problem self-defense.
Mm-hmm. When he grabs it like that, it means he's hungry.
Hey, Doc, how soon before I can get out of here? Coming along nicely. Wait a minute.
place and take it easy a little while longer.
We'll rehearse it.
Sure. You can go on tonight.
What's that?
Sure, I'll let you take a couple of bucks. After the show.
Yeah. Sam.
Sam.
That's a society name. I want you to go out front and make a great big sign. Put it up on top. Extra, added, special attraction.
Hello, William.
Hello, William.
Welcome home, Mr. Carpenter. Mrs. Weatherby.
May I offer my congratulations?
Thank you, William.
Yes, darling.
Oh, she went out. Said she'd be a little late. Do anything else?
No, no, that's all.
Oh, Williams.
Yes, sir.
Mrs. Weatherby has told me everything that's happened. We both appreciate all you've done.
Thank you.
You'll, of course, get your back salary, and between tomorrow, your salary will be raised $25 tomorrow.
Considering everything, don't you think it'd be better if I were to leave?
Nonsense. I'm just to get everything, and you'll be back to your old position.
Well, I'll take it over.
Oh, by the way, what time is Joey?
3 o'clock.
I wonder where she can be.
I don't know, but wherever she is, she's like the party.
The meaning of this. Ain't everybody presented a court hearing?
That's what Tom
said. You'll be late tonight. I expect we're going together.
Okay, be right now. Yes.
Oh, where is she?
In jail.
What happened before?
I don't know, but whatever it is, she did it.
Now, this is no time for Joey.
Now, don't get excited, dear. Come on, Wheels, we'll get her out.
I'll go with you.
You stay here.
Thank you.
But what is she in for? 50 days. Unless you want to pay $50. Pay the clerk.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Jerry, you don't know how glad I am to see you.
This is certainly a fine welcome home, you business.
Oh, now, don't start scolding.
If you have no regard for your own reputation, please have some consideration for your sister and myself.
Now, you listen to me, Jerry, Weatherby. Just because you're married to my sister, there's no time you can tell me what to do.
Mr. Weatherby's right. There's no excuse for this sort of thing.
And you keep out of this. Of all the people in the world, you should be the last one to say anything. And if it hadn't been...
I beg your pardon, Miss Stewart. I forgot myself. It won't happen again. Hey, lady. What is it, officer?
Oh. Beg your pardon.
Never mind. Sister, you can send it back.
Hello, Miss Carroll. Come in, children.
The newlywed. Oh, congratulations. I hope you'll be very happy.
They're just like a couple of lovebirds.
Thank you.
Yes, Ma.
Hello. Won't you come inside?
We just got in to say goodbye.
Well, when are you leaving?
Tomorrow morning.
Did you have a nice honeymoon?
Oh, yes. It was grand.
Did you go too?
Sure. I always did want to see Niagara Falls. It's no good without a honeymoon. So I just tagged along.
Yes?
Mr. Weatherby is driving Miss Geraldine, Mom. We'll be here in a few moments.
I'd like to say goodbye to Tom. You mind?
Oh, if I know, go ahead.
Hello, Mr. Jones.
You leaving?
Yes.
Where are you going?
I don't know. Anyway, get away from here.
Tom, you were never cut out to be a chauffeur. I'll give you a real job. Why don't you come out west with me?
I'm sorry, but I can't.
What is it?
A girl? No.
You got any money?
Okay, bye.
I owe you $1,000.
No, I can't take it.
Why?
Well, I can't take it.
Is it on account of Annette?
No, of course not.
Listen, son, you don't have to lie. I was a bit secure myself for 20 years, and I spotted her for a pop wrestler the minute I laid eyes on her. I knew it all the time. She's a good girl, and she'll make me a good wife when I get through with it.
Well, if she's ever half as good as you are, that'll be plenty.
Oh, shucks. The train leaves tomorrow morning at 10. Will you be there?
You bet I will.
You won't be sorry, son. I guess we'd have to be running along. Now, the children. All right, Phineas.
On behalf of my wife and myself, I want to thank you for bringing us together and all you've done for us.
Hey, Winter,
if you ever come to Nevada, you must visit us. We'd love to have you.
Well, thank you very much. I'd love to. Yes. Where's Tom with?
He's in his room.
Good. Full of old, sweet looking outfits.
Annette,
Goodbye, Mr. Jones. Nice to see you. I want to talk to you.
Well, I'm listening.
Why did you walk out on me?
Because I felt like it.
Don't talk to me that way. I was happy.
No? Why don't you listen to me? You were beginning to be a real human being, but just as soon as a few dollars came back into the family, you went right back to what you were, an 18-carat pain in the neck. Well, I wouldn't take it from you if you were the last woman in the world. I'm through. I'm quitting. Oh, here. Hello.
Where are you going?
Well, if you must know about it, Annie Jones is giving me a real job.
Do you suppose she could use a maid, too?
Why?
Well, even in Nevada, the chauffeur always gives her the maid.
Oh, what's the use?